Clean energy is the hot topic today, but it was also the driving force behind this movie from 1996. After doing Bill and Ted stuff, Keanu Reeves wanted to be taken more seriously as an actor. To that end, he started appearing in less goofy roles, starting with My Own Private Idaho in 1991, Dracula in 1992, and Much Ado About Nothing the following year in 1993. Then came his big break, Speed, from 1994. This cemented Reeves as a box office draw and a bona fide star. Between Speed and his other big smash hit, The Matrix, in 1999, he did a few other films, including this one, Chain Reaction. Chain Reaction tells the tale of Eddie Kosalovich, who is working with a team of researchers trying to create a fusion reactor. The leader of the project is a hippie-type utopian who sees this reactor as a means of producing clean energy that could save mankind. He intends to release his research on the internet as a gift to the world. Unfortunately, shadowy government types have a different idea. They foresee this clean energy reactor as a threat to global stock exchanges and economies. See, you'd naturally think the bad guys would be an oil company, but here it's a covert government agency. Anyway, Kosalovich is the brilliant machinist who comes up with the fix that makes this reactor work. They call him a machinist, but really, he seems to be a lot more than that, like an inventor or something. Anyhow, the reactor works. That night, after a celebration party, Kosalovich nobly makes sure his hot British co-worker gets home safely because she's had too much to drink. Then, he stops by the lab to pick up his motorcycle and notices all hell's breaking loose. The reactor is running wild. A co-worker who should be there is missing, and his mentor is dead. He barely escapes a massive explosion when the reactor pops its top. The FBI comes calling, and Kosalovich and the cute Brit both realize they're being framed for murder and treason. They decide to go on the lam. Their only friend is the head of a research foundation involved in the project. Now the pair is being chased by the police, the FBI, and the shadowy killer organization. And they don't know where to turn. They start putting the pieces together, but who's behind all this? Who's framing them, and who can they turn to? The setting here is Chicago in wintertime, and it looks great. The industrial areas add a nice look to the proceeding. This is actually a pretty good action movie, although they do fall back on one trick over and over. Namely, they have Reeves running in practically every scene to convey action. Seriously, he does a lot of running. like it's almost comical, the sheer amount of running he has to do in this movie. There's a drinking game here, I'm telling you. Rachel Weisz is the cute Brit scientist, and I gotta say, I really liked her in this role. Even though she's cute, she's still believable as a scientist. So the filmmakers didn't fall back on the old trope of the girl just being there to be sexy. In fact, they deviate from the action movie formula in this regard. She and Reeves don't actually become romantically involved in the picture. Normally, you would expect the couple to have makeouts, right? but they don't, although they do convey an attraction to one another, so that was different. Morgan Freeman, I just love him in this role. He's sort of a good guy, but is he sort of a bad guy? He's playing it calm in the face of FBI questioning. You don't quite know his motivation or which way he'll go, good or bad. He talks around things and you can just see the wheels turning in his mind. A great performance in what for most actors would be just another paycheck role. Freeman brings some interesting angles to his character. And can I just say, Morgan Freeman here, his sartorial splendor is unmatched in this movie. I mean, look at those awesome threads. Kinda businessy, kinda professional, but also kinda casual. Wouldn't you want to wear that outfit? I would so wear that outfit. He looks great. And I have to mention Fred Ward here, who plays the FBI agent in charge. I really loved him. He just nailed it. He reminded me of Ephraim Zimbalist Jr. from the old FBI TV series. Originally, his character was supposed to be a reprise of Tommy Lee Jones's character from The Fugitive and U.S. Marshals. But when that fell through, Ward was cast and the character changed. He's very good here. Director Andrew Davis certainly knew how to make good action movies. The aforementioned The Fugitive was his. He also did Under Siege and Code of Silence. I'm giving this one 2.5 paws. It may be a little flawed, but Chain Reaction offers some good action, and Morgan Freeman really delivers. Plus, the clean energy angle is still relevant today. Chain Reaction is available on VHS, DVD, Blu-ray, and digitally from Amazon Prime. Well, I'll be back soon with another video. You take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the next one.